Hi, welcome to another reading vlog. So this week we're going to be doing this vlog. Today is Tuesday and this vlog is going to run till Sunday. Sorry about the noise. This week I actually have a lot to do. I'm planning to read some books for the Folkathon. I don't know which yet, but I've already read one book, Diary of Blood. A Diary of Blood for what was the name of? Read a book with a polyamorous relationship. Read that one. So I'm going to read more books for the Folkathon. I can't really think of which. I can't think of anyone right now, but I already have some down, and I guess as I read, I will just tell you which one. And then I have to read two books for two different book clubs. There's Open Water by Caleb something and Transcendent Kingdom by Yagyasi for the Indulgent Bibliophile book club. And then Open Water is for another book club, I think Happy Noisemaker book club. So I have to read those two and then just any other thing that I see that I want to read. Oh, I want to read Red, White, and Royal Blue. I've already started it. I've not gone far. I just read like two lines. And then The Office Party too. So, that's my plan for this week. Oh, and I'm also doing my project this week. So, you'll be seeing a little bit of that soon. Hi, so, today is Thursday and it's like 4:30 to 5-ish. And so far, I have not really read anything. Why? Because my project is just taking up all my time, you know. If you see any final year students in Nigeria or abroad, or wherever you are, final year students working on project or paper or anything, just buy them a bottle of coke, because this life is very difficult. Anyway, so I haven't read anything, but I've actually started a lot of books. So I started Red, White, and Royal Blue, and I'm like 42%. I'm like 42% into the book, and so far I honestly don't know how to feel. I'm just okay, like no outstanding emotions. Oh, and I started Open Water too. However, this book, I feel like I should be feeling things, but I'm not feeling anything. It's just there. Like I want to feel things. Oh, if you're hearing any noise, I'm so sorry. I think it's AC or something. And then it is raining, so I think you might hear thunder, a bit lightning. I don't know which of them makes the sound, but my head out. So I started Open Water, and so far it's just okay. I can tell that it's a good book, and this is something people like, but I don't know. The writing style is just taking me out. Like, it's very poetic, and I won't say flowery, but it's quite poetic. I feel like if I had listened to it as an audiobook, I'd probably like it better, because it's feeling somewhat like books. You know how a book written in verse is? That's how I feel like this book is. It's not written in verse. It's like quite kind of really poetic and stuff. And I feel like if I had listened to it as an audiobook, I probably enjoyed it more, but I'm not listening to it as an audiobook. I'm reading it physically, I'd be ebook-wise, but I'm not enjoying it as much, and the writing is just kind of taking me out. Like, I'm not feeling the emotions I'm supposed to be feeling. I'm just there. But the book is giving me serious Umi vibes. If you don't know Umi, she's like a musician. That's the best I know how to explain her. And I'm trying to listen to Umi while reading, but I have not done that yet. But I still plan to doing so. Oh, and I got Black Flamingo on script. And I'm going to try to read that one too. Hopefully before the week runs out. So I am here to give you guys a little bit of update on all I've been reading so far. So far, I haven't really read anything. Today's Saturday, and I haven't made any serious progress in any of the books that I started this week. And it's so funny because I am wrapping up this video tomorrow, and I don't know if I'm going to complete any of this book. Hopefully, I hope I do, but I doubt that I will do that. Anyway, so the books, I think I'm just going to focus on trying to complete the books that I have already started, so at least we'll have something to talk about tomorrow. So I started Open Water, and I haven't really made a lot of progress. And for this book, I started it in a week and then I dropped it, and for some reason I have not really picked it back up. And it's kind of sad because I wasn't really anticipating the book, but I really wanted to like it because there's a lot of feels in this book, and I'm not really feeling the feelings I'm supposed to be feeling. And I'm just sad because the book is quite kind of really poetic and stuff. And I thought, oh, okay. I used to think that I was really into flowery language, but this isn't really flowery language. It's just really poetic in a way. And I thought, oh, I was really going to like this. But for some reason, I'm not really into the book. Like, the story is okay. But at least from what I've seen so far, the story is okay. But I'm not just into it. It's just there for me. And it's so sad that the reason why I am not really into this book is because of the writing, which I should love but don't. I don't know, it's just taking me out of the story. The writing is just taking me out of the story, and I don't know what to do with that. But hopefully I'll be able to finish it because I need to read it for my book club, the Happy Noisemaker book club. And it's not like I made the book club, it's a book club that I am in. Or at least I try to participate in. But anyway, hopefully I'll be able to finish this. And then I started Red, White, and Royal Blue. I'm like 42% into this book. And this one too, this book is one of the books. This is a really hype book. And everybody I have seen, even my friend, has read the book and she really loves it. And I was just like, oh, damn, this is going to be like it for me. And honestly, I'm like 42% into this book, and so far it's just there, it's just okay. And I'm kind of sad because I really wanted to be obsessed with Henry and Alex, but I'm just okay, and I feel like I'm missing out on something. And then I started the Black Flamingo too. I think I started that one recently, and I'm almost done with this one. Like, I just have like two chapters left, and I'll be done. And so far, this book also, everybody loves it. Like, I looked at Goodreads and everybody always has something good to say about the book, and I was just like, yes, this is going to be it. And sadly, this is just, it's not a bad book. Like, it's a really nice book and something I feel everybody should read because it's such a good book and talks about so many important things. But I'm just there, like, I'm just neutral. I'm just like, oh, okay, this is okay. Like, I'm looking, I don't know, this month, everything has just been three stars for me. And I don't know, I've not been obsessed with anything. Like, I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. And then, oh, I have finished one book though. I read Blue is the Warmest Color. This was a graphic novel. And this one, I think I gave this book 3 stars too. And this book, it was actually an okay book. It was like it's a coming of age story about this young girl, and she learns that she's actually into women, and then just like following her life. And this is not a spoiler because it happens like on the first page. She dies, and then so the her love interest, Emma, is given a letter where the girl, the main person, Emma, who dies, Abby Clementine, who dies, asks her to go back to her house and Abby her parents' house and read her diary so she will learn about her life and everything. So we follow Clementine, she reads Clementine, Emma. We follow Emma as she goes back to Clementine's parents' house, reads her journal, Abby her diary, and then just learn about her life. And it's a good book, it's an interesting book. The drawing was definitely nice, it was interesting. I don't know how to review drawing because I can't draw. I don't know, but it was nice to look at. And then there's this thing they do when we go back to the past, where at that point Clementine has blue hair, and I guess that's like one of the things that instantly attracts
Clementine to Emma. I'm so sorry if I'm mixing up the names, but and then when we go back to the past, there's no color. It's like this very, is it monochromic? But like everything is just plain and brown, and then only the color blue is being like the only color being shown. I'm so sorry if you can hear that the noise right now. It's the gen. It just turned on the gen. But anyway, you only see the color blue, which to show that that's like Emma's, I mean Clementine's favorite color, and Emma's hair is blue, and I guess that's one of the things that instantly attracts her to Emma, and it's just it was really cool. But yeah, I thought it was a really okay book. But however, there are just two things in this book that I did not really like. Oh, it's a car, it's not even the gen. Okay, I think the noise has stopped now. But okay, so there are just two things in this book that I really did not like. It's just something I don't like generally. Well, there was cheating in this book, and I'm just, when I see cheating, I'm just like, no. No, I'm sorry. It's like, because it was like, I tried to get behind them, and I thought that the two, Emma, Clementine and Emma, they were cute and sweet together and everything. But Emma had a girlfriend when they started seeing each other. It was just like, I was just like, no, I'm sorry, no. And then Emma is on that, Clementine was like 16 when she met Emma, and from what I understand, Emma was like way older, like already legal age. I don't know, she was shy in her 20s, and I know the age difference was not much, but still, I know the age difference wasn't a lot, but she was still underage, and it was just like, I was just like, no, I'm sorry, no. Like, apart from those two things, the book was, it was really okay. I guess if not for those two things, the book would have probably gotten a higher rating for me. But it's not for me. So, but it was an okay book. I feel like people who read it, because I saw a lot of really wonderful reviews on Goodreads, but I just could not get over those two things. But apart from that, it was a beautiful book. Then, what else have I read? I've started a lot of books. Jesus. I feel like I'm forgetting something. I've just been there. Hopefully, I'll finish something before the end of this, because I've just been starting and stopping books. Start new one, stop. So, I'm even thinking of starting a new one now. So. Anyway, update you tomorrow. Monday, and I was supposed to wrap up this video yesterday, Sunday, but I did not wrap it up because yesterday was kind of really busy and I did not get the chance to really make any visible progress in any of the books I started. So I just decided to extend the vlog and make it 2 weeks, and then just try and complete these books that I've already set up my mind to finish. And then I think after this vlog, I'm not going to be vlogging for some time, because one, my exam is coming up, I think the first or second week of July, and vlogging is not, I don't do like hardcore serious vlogging or anything, but it kind of takes time, like take me, forget my attention. But yeah, I think I need to concentrate a bit on my mock, so I might not make any vlog videos for some time, but I might still be able to get some, like pre-record some videos. Hopefully I might be able to also. I'll be posting that for some time, and I guess if you don't see me, I drop out of the face of the earth again, like I always do, just know that I'm writing an exam. Anyway, but let's go back to the books now. And so I haven't made any visible progress, but just updates in the books I'm reading. Red, White and Royal Blue, I'm almost done. I just have 3 hours left in the audiobook, and so far, at the beginning I was like, oh, I'm missing out on something, I'm not really feeling it, but then I
started feeling it, you know, catching feelings along with Alex and Henry, and I'm really there with them. I really like them. They're very cute. I like their chemistry. I like their pants. I like everything about them. They're cute. And then I finished the Black Flamingo, and I gave it 4 stars to anyone. Just they can hear noise in the background of other people talking. I'm sorry. Bear with me. But anyway, the ending of Black Flamingo was so nice and was just beautiful and wonderful and heartwarming, and it made me smile a lot. I was just like, 4 stars, baby girl. So anyway, apart from the Black Flamingo, I can't even remember. Oh, I finished the Office Party too. I don't know if I mentioned that I was also reading the Office Party. Sorry. I don't know if I mentioned that I was reading the Office Party, which is a novella, and I think I gave it 2 stars because I don't know, it was cute, it was nice. Okay, it wasn't cute, it was really steamy. And I don't know. I liked it, I thought it was okay. It's just that there are just too many things that do not feel realistic to me. I'm just like, I can't get behind this because of the many factors and issues that my head keeps bringing up. And I feel like they are not really big issues, and it's things that you just want to read something without necessarily looking at these things. They are okay, they are not really problematic, but it's just a cute, nice book to just read when you are feeling wacky and happy. And is that it's a really funny book? It's just I just couldn't, so which is why I think I'm going to give it 2 stars. But it's a really good book. I feel like I'll be more coherent and be able to put my thoughts together in my wrap up if I do a wrap up. Anyway, that's just I think I finished those two, and then Open Water. I still have not been able to find that book. Like, I tried to read it yesterday. I only got through one page before I put it down. Because I don't know, I'm not enjoying it, but I have to finish it. If not, I feel like I would have DNF'd it at this point. But I'm not really enjoying myself. I feel like, oh, I forgot to mention that book is written in, I think, second person. I used to think I did not have a problem with that, because I think I read another book that used that, and I did not like it. It was just an okay read, so I felt like I did not have a problem with this thing. But maybe I do. I don't really know why, but something is just not letting me be invested the way I want to be, and because of that, I'm not really enjoying it. It's just, or maybe I don't just have enough principles to process what is going on, because the writing style is just—it's a bit complex for me, and maybe that's—I think that's what's taking me out. Yeah. But anyway, apart from that, I added more books. I started reading more books. Like, I already can't wrap up any of the books I'm reading, and I'm just adding more. So I started One Year of Ugly today, and I haven't really gone far. I'm still in chapter one. And then I'm reading One Year of Ugly because this month is also the Caribbean Heritage Month, and I'm trying to get some books by Caribbean, read some books by Caribbean authors too. I haven't really made progress in that as much as I would like to, but there are some books that I'm eyeing, and I feel like I want to mention them, but I feel like I might not end up reading them, so I don't want to be mentioning books that I've not read. But I feel like I might finish One Year of Ugly before this vlog ends, which is why I'm mentioning, because it's, I know I'm just one chapter in, but I'm already really invested in what's going on. So yeah, anyway, catch you. Hi guys, so today is Tuesday, it's like 5:30 Tuesday, and I've decided to end the vlog here. I know this vlog was supposed to run till Friday, but I decided to end here because I know I'm technically done with school, but I'm still doing my project, and then I have an exam coming up. Well, a mock main exam is in August, but I have a mock exam coming up in July, and the whole school thing is just becoming really intense, so I kind of need to focus on my exam. And whenever I make a vlog, a reading vlog, I always like try to focus on my energy on reading all the books I set out to read, so I don't concentrate on education. But I need to concentrate on education now, so I decided to end the vlog here and just like try and balance myself and actually, I don't know what the word is, but just actually I'm just trying to like find balance and just okay. I'm going to patch in some videos very soon and just like post that one for the time being. But for now,
think I need to start preparing for my exam. So anyway, for this vlog, I think I completed 4 or 5 books. I finished Red, White and Blue, Red, White and Royal Blue, and I gave that 4 stars. It was beautiful, it was funny, it was everything wholesome, it was just heartwarming. I loved it. I loved the banters, the emails between Alex and Henry just give me life and give me joy and everything, all the serotonin boost I need, I get it from them. So yes, I gave Red, White and Royal Blue 4 stars. Then I finished The Black Flamingo, gave that 4 stars too because it was just beautiful and just, it was a wonderful read and I was so glad that I read that book. It was just heartwarming. Oh, and then I finished The Office Party, which is a novella, and for this one I gave it 2 stars because it was actually really funny and it was okay. On a normal day I would have given it 3 stars, just that there were some things that just felt too unrealistic for me and I was just like, can't really get behind it, so I gave it 2 stars. But apart from that, I think the book actually did what it set out to do and it was a really good read. It's just I could not get behind some of this because I just felt like it just feels too unrealistic. And even if I am not a working class lady and I don't know how 9 to 5 jobs actually are, so I can't really say. It just felt unrealistic to my student self, so I gave that 2 stars. And then I read Warm Blue is a Woman's Color and I gave that 3 stars. I can't really remember if I read anything else, but those 4 I can solidly remember. And I also started some other books. I wasn't able to finish Open Water, but I definitely have to finish it before the 25th of this month because that's when my book club is going to talk about it. So have to finish that. And oh, and I started One Year of Ugly and I'm just like 3 pages into it and I'm really enjoying it and I actually wish I could vlog my experience, but you know, have to take a break, you know, dive down a little bit because I have to start taking education seriously. So but I started those 2 and I'm not done with them. Hopefully I'll be done with them. And I think that's all for now, Sha. So anyway, if you watch this vlog to this point with me, thank you for watching me so far and see you next time.